short story or two. The thing is, I like that. I can just put anything I want in there, so I have a new journal that I'm going to use that's just a plain unlined paper. It's more like a sketchbook, but I'm going to actually use it as a journal and write in it too. Chat a little bit about just life in general, how things are going, that kind of thing. But also sounds. I don't know if you can hear it, but there's a air conditioning unit pumping air into the building, into my office. I can hear it. It's very relaxing, actually. It's been hot the past couple days. I don't know why that is. Weather. In the comments, why don't you tell me how you handle hot weather? I was talking to someone recently about the things you get used to in life, and I will tell you this. When I was younger, when I was a kid, I grew up in Florida on the Key Coast, on the Gulf Coast. Just get used to it. It's funny because ASMR is one of those things where the triggers can be different for every person, and the triggers for one person might not affect another person at all, and some people don't even get any sensation. Graduate school, and my family was all the way on the other side of the country. Kind of messed up our travel plans, but anyway, I was having trouble, especially in the first 3 months, sleeping, and that is when I found ASMR and started doing ASMR, and I started initially posting videos. If you go back and look at my oldest videos, I was walking trail in the forest, right across from where my apartment was, and that's how I started. And I was listening to ASMR, and all of the ASMR artists are still putting videos up. So I've done a video about this before, but the people that I really liked were GB, Frivy, Fox, Raffy Zaffy, and a few others. And their ASMR got me through that 3 months of not seeing anyone and being in my apartment and trying to work on my thesis that I had to write. And it was helpful because I couldn't sleep. I don't know if you went through that kind of thing or not, but I did. I was comfortable in my apartment, and I had the trails I could walk on, and I enjoyed recording the videos I was doing then. If you went back and looked at them, they're interesting because I'm moving the whole time on the trail. To me, they were interesting. They were fun to do. But late at night, I would have trouble relaxing and falling asleep. And I had an app on my phone with ocean sounds, which was really helpful. But then I found ASMR, and I would listen to some Fox, and it was so helpful. I'd relax and I'd be able to go to sleep. Relax and go to sleep. I really enjoyed it, and it was helpful. Subscriber away themselves, but sometimes it will be that they will use it as a way to practice. Being assertive or addressing a certain issue with a person, whether they really do or not, it can be helpful. You may not know what's really causing the tension. Is it work? Is it a relationship? Is it anger? Or frustration? Is it something that you're carrying from your childhood that's coming forward, that might be in your unconscious that you're not aware of? That's the thing. We have all these processes going on all the time behind the scenes. It's like you don't consciously think, oh, I have to take a breath, while there are other things happening in your mind. And your heart, they're all functioning independently of your thought. It's part of the autonomic system. There are unconscious processes in your mind that are happening all the time too. There are schools of thought that are very reductionistic and say, well, if you can't measure, it's not there. But when it comes to the unconscious mind, I think that you have brainwave activity when you're asleep, and that has been measured, and you're not aware sometimes of all the things. is about developing a different approach, a different therapy for every person. And I think that's helpful. I think that's true. Not that there's anything wrong with specific models, cognitive behavioral therapy, or acceptance and commitment therapy, or dialectic behavioral therapy. They're helpful for certain people. But I think everyone can find a benefit from therapy, because it allows you to take that time to explore yourself and what's going on, and learn to just live a better, more conscious life. At least that's the way I look at it, and how I try to approach every situation. I don't do my therapy. I don't do my counseling practice for the money. I could make more money if I did other things, things I've done in the past. But I like the independence of what I'm doing, and I also like to help people. And I'm enjoying it, and I'm having fun. And I think that I'm at that point in my life where if it's not fun, I'm not going to do it. If I don't enjoy it or think I'm helpful, I'm not going to do it. So again, that's my opinion. Some more videos in the next couple days, because I would love to get to 1,000 subscribers. So if you haven't subscribed, please do so, and like the video if you like it. Leave a comment, and I will be happy to get back to you or try to do a video that you suggest.